Hello and welcome to this tutorial where I'll show you how to use the Terrain Remix Brushes add-on for Blender. It's an add-on for creating realistic looking terrains in a very fast and intuitive way. It also has a way of scattering a vegetation, rocks, and applying a procedural material system. In this video, I'll just cover the basics while I create other three videos, one for explaining how to create your own custom brushes with your custom height maps, and two videos, one for the vegetation and rock scattering, and a video for the material system, going into much more detail. So this add-on will be sold together with the same add-on but built for the Unreal Engine. So if you buy one, you get both. And I hope you will enjoy this tutorial. To install the add-on, once you've downloaded the file, you're gonna unzip this. I'm gonna extract here with 7-zip. And then you have these two files, another compressed archive and the folder. Now let me delete this. So I've already extracted, and now let's open up Blender. Inside the Blender, you're going to go into Edit, Preferences, under Add-ons, you're going to click on Install, and you're going to navigate to the folder where you've extracted your two items. There you're going to select the zip file. You're going to enable this. And when you open up, you have to reference the asset path. And the asset path is this one, the folder which you've extracted. Hit accept. Now last thing, under file paths, you have to add a user library. You click on plus and you reference the same folder, TRB underscore assets. You click on OK and you make sure that you leave the name like this, TRB underscore assets. So once you've installed the add-on, let me show you how to use it. I'm gonna delete these three, close this area down here. Now when I press N key here at the side, you will see a new side panel called Terrain Remix Brushes. From there I can create a landscape. And when I zoom out to see the whole landscape, you're gonna see it starts clipping. That's because under view, we have to adjust our end view distance to 10 kilometers instead of one for this terrain. And there you go, our whole terrain is visible again. Now, when you hit edit mode, you're gonna see this asset browser come up from the bottom. And while in edit mode, I recommend you to only use brushes. There's three types of assets here. There's brushes, there's materials, and there's scatters. And yeah, let's take a look. There's three types of brushes. There's peaks, which are basically mountains. There's slope details, which add detail to areas with not so much detail. And there's valleys, which can be used to cut into the terrain. So let's start creating a landscape by dropping in a mountain. How about we choose this peak 46 here. I drop it in and the mountain magically appears on our terrain. Now this mountain can be edited. And for example, it can be scaled by using the S key. It can be rotated, but I've added a few shortcuts. So for rotation, I've added the U key for rotating around the Z axis. Because if I rotate with the R key, you're gonna see the terrain starts stretching in weird ways. Then I've added another shortcut for moving, the J key. With the J key, you can move along the XY plane. That's because if you move like with a normal G key, you see that the terrain starts bending also in unexpected ways. And the last short key I added is the L key. Now with the L key, you can toggle your brush, for example, change the fall off strength. So at zero, you'll get these straight edges. And you can change a few other things like this profile, which basically makes the mountain more pointy or more rounded. And what else? Here there's a cutoff feature which makes a plateau at a certain height of your terrain. And yeah, let you play around with these for yourself. So now I'm just gonna start creating the terrain and I will speed up this part of the tutorial. So see you around. So once you're satisfied with your terrain, you can exit edit mode. Now let's take a look at some of the settings here under general settings. All these settings can actually be accessed also here under modifier. That's because I'm using geometry nodes here to make this system work. And yeah, there's ways for changing the size of your terrain. You can change to whatever non-square rectangular shape you want. And there's ways for changing the resolution. If you take a look at the viewport shading here, our terrain is composed of a lot of little squares. And right now, our longest side is composed of 512 squares. So there's also a way of changing the render resolution, which basically will only apply when we hit render image. And that's an easy way to save on RAM, because if your resolution goes high, your computer needs to have a lot of RAM. I usually recommend not to go above 2000 or to experiment a bit yourself. There's also this adaptive subdivision, which changes the density of the resolution based on a distance from a certain point. You can define it as a camera, for example. Then you can change the shape also like this. I'm gonna keep this disabled for now. Let's go back to normal shading here. And let's go back to normal shape, square shape. And let's change the resolution to 2000 to see what this looks like at higher detail. And yeah, as you can see, there's quite a lot of detail here in these brushes. Actually, all of the brushes are 4000 by 4000 in resolution, so you can go ahead and use a quite high resolution if your computer can handle it. Then there's this white maps feature here, which if you click on enable, it's gonna take a while to compile. And to preview this, you go into materials and you drop the weight maps here onto your terrain. When you click on viewport shading, you will see that all this erosion information has been added to your terrain by the brushes. This can be really helpful for coloring in really realistic ways afterwards, and also for the scattering systems. For example, the rocks will gather here only in these erosion lines and things like this. So lastly, there is also a way of backing the height map to an image. For that, you need to save your file somewhere, and you can click on bake height map. Once that's done, you can also pull up in the image editor and search for this height map. And there you go. We have our height map of the terrain baked, and you can export it as an image. So I think now it's time to show you some of the texturing, and later I will show you also a bit of scattering. So to change the material of a terrain, we're gonna go here under materials, and I'm just gonna drop in this default material onto the terrain. Then I'm gonna change the render engine to cycles, GPU, put on the denoise, and under world I'm gonna use sky texture with a strength of 0.1. So let's check out our terrain and viewport shading now. And let's bring this window to be a bit bigger. You can see the material gets updated and creates this procedural material with a lot of different layers. Snow, rock, grass, and gravel. Some get placed with rules like erosion flows and slope and height, to create a really organic looking material. I'm gonna turn this floor off for a moment, and let's change maybe some of the sky direction here. Yeah, like this maybe. And yeah, I will show you for a moment what it would look like to edit this material a bit for yourself, to maybe change the masks and the color of your terrain. So for that, you go into shader editor, you zoom out, and you have a look at this little spaghetti monster. It's a bit scary, but I'll explain it in much further detail in another video. Right now, I'll just show you quickly how you could maybe change the colors in this area down here. Say your grass looks a bit boring right now. We could add a little bit of a different color, maybe lighten it up a bit. Turn the saturation down, Can see if I slide this around, it's gonna change the look of our terrain drastically. Maybe this is a bit too greenish. I want something a bit more yellow. Turn the saturation down. And yeah, you can also change some of the hue. Maybe 0.47 and make it a bit more yellowish. And turn the saturation down from here. Say our gravel right now, we want our gravel to be a bit more blue. For that, we can also change the hue here on our gravel. Add some saturation maybe. And put the hue to, yeah, one. It already looks more blue. How about the rock? Also looking a bit too pinkish right now. We turn the saturation up. And at 0.4, it looks a bit closer to this gravel color here. Let's maybe turn the value or the lightness of this up a bit. And yeah, that's how you can quickly change the look of your terrain. You can also change some of the masks in this third section here. Say, for example, we want a bit more snow on our terrain. We go here under snow mask and we change the value of our snow line. We can lower the snow line, maybe add some fall off. Make the mask a bit softer. And yeah, so you want to have a bit more gravel on our terrain, we can change on the gravel mask, add a bit more, a bit less of the flow lines. And I will explain a lot of this in much further detail in another video, as said at the beginning. Right now, maybe we just check out some of these other presets which I created. So yeah, the Dolomite has a distinct color of this rose-looking rock. Then maybe we check out this red bloom. The red bloom adds these red parts to the grass, and right now they're a bit too strong. So for that, we can go into our color here and change the line of our red to make it appear in fewer areas. Like this. Then there's this other material for making a bit more desert look. So that's it for the materials. I think I'll apply this default material again and I will show you the scattering. So now I've set up some rock scattering. As you can see here in the outliner, there's three types of rocks. There's big rocks, there's medium rocks, and there's small rocks. And the ways these get scattered is by using these boxes here. And the boxes are going to decide where these rocks are going to be scattered. That's why I put these boxes to be just under the snow line, because I don't want these rocks to be scattered on the snow, because this might look weird. And yeah, you can see there's quite a lot of small rocks and big rocks scattered all on our terrain. And there's a lot of different settings as well here on the side. There's under modifiers for each one of these. There's ways of controlling density and the size and the rotation and other things, which I'll go over in much more detail in another video. So now let me show you some of the vegetation scattering. So now I've scattered some vegetation on the terrain. If we switch to viewport shading, you're gonna see if I select this fir tree scatter, all these trees have been scattered in following certain rules like altitude and some erosion as well. Then I've used this broadleaf tree scatter device to scatter some bushes actually. It's not really trees, it's more small bushes. And yeah, if I turn these overlays off, the performance is gonna get a bit better. And let's check out what it looks like in rendered mode. There you go. You've got a lot of little bushes here and some nice fir trees. And yeah, that's basically what you can achieve with the vegetation scattering. This is all the functionality of the Blender add-on Terrain Remix Brushes. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you have some feedback for me, please leave it in the comments. If you have some suggestions of what I can add next to the add-on, or if you found some bugs, please let me know.